Good morning, students. Welcome to Academic World School online classes of 12th biology. So in the first video you have learned about reproduction in organism. In this we have talked about the type of reproduction, asexual and sexual. What is the lifespan, and it is the time period between the birth to the death, right? So we have covered all this. So today we are going to talk about types of asexual reproduction. There are few different types in this asexual reproduction, in which the organisms are formed from the single parent. In this, there is no formation and fusion of gamete taking place, and the offspring of this kind asexual reproduction are also known as clones, since they are morphologically and genetically identical offsprings. Yes, so there are some subtypes of asexual reproduction which today we are going to cover. First one is the fission, second is the budding, and then spore formation, fragmentation and regeneration, and then coming to the vegetative propagation, which will have various kind. So these are the subtopic which today we are going to cover, right? So here is the first one, fission. Since I told in asexual reproduction only one organism or one parent is involved, in this asexual reproduction first type fission, the parent which will be there involved, they will be having certain divisions, and due to the divisions their body will be differentiated into new individuals. Now based on the division, this fission is actually of two major type. One is called as binary fission, and the other one is the multiple fission. Fission is of two type, binary fission and multiple fission. And from the name also we can correlate that this binary fission means one single cell will be differentiated into two equal daughter cells from the parent body itself. And multiple fission means from one parent body there will be formation of multiple daughter cells. Now coming to this binary fission, it's look quite simple that binary fission two daughter cells, but it's not, because it is also based on the plane of cytokinesis. Plane of cytokinesis means how the cytoplasma is getting distributed in two daughter cells. Based on that, this fission, binary fission, is further differentiated into other type. That is, number one, irregular binary fission. Irregular binary fission, because the cytoplasm from the parent body to the offspring, it will be distributed irregularly, and this happen in case of amoeba. And this amoeba itself is a irregular organism. So you can imagine an organism having the irregular body whose symmetry we can't tell, so definitely the cytoplasm distribution also will be irregular. So when this organism multiply, what happens in their body is their irregular body will be having the nucleus, and this nucleus starts elongating, and after elongation of this nucleus there will be constriction in the body of this amoeba, and we can observe that there is the two nuclei. This nucleus has been differentiated into two different nucleus, right? So we call it nuclei. So now we can see here this nucleus separating, and after this, this parent will be divided equally in two daughter, cell. So after the constriction and the division of the nucleus into two equal part, there is two daughter cell formed. So this is irregular binary fission. So I hope you are taking the notes. Don't forget to write all the notes and do follow up all the types with example. This is the one irregular binary fission in the amoeba. Now we will move to the other type of binary fission. After irregular binary fission, now the cytokinesis happens in longitudinal way. So it is known as longitudinal binary fission. In longitudinal binary fission, mostly this happens in case of certain organism, like I can list Leishmania, and even you can list out the example of Euglena. These are the example in which longitudinal binary fission takes place. And in this, if I draw a diagram, this kind of organism will be having the anterior part like this and the posterior part like this, having a nucleus inside it and a flagella also. So when this flagella is present in the anterior part, in the first step of the division, it always gets initiated from the anterior end. See properly how I am drawing the diagram, because this is the way how the division will be taking place. So this nucleus will be getting elongated here also, because it has to be getting distributed in both the daughter cell which is going to be formed. So you have seen here, first the parent organism is there, and it is this division has started from the anterior end, and then there will be the division which is, I can say, a little elongated, and the bifurcation also we can see clearly, because in this step posterior end is still joined, but the nucleus has been divided equally and it is having the flagella in it. And in the next step, when the longitudinal binary fission, it means cytoplasm has equally getting distributed in both the body, then it is getting divided and it will be forming a new individual. So you can see this very clearly what is happening over there. In this longitudinal binary fission, it takes place in Leishmania and in Euglena. The body is bifurcated into two equal daughter cells, and the cytoplasm is also equally distributed. This distribution is taking place along the, I can say, longitudinal axis. So the fission is taking place here in the longitudinal axis. I hope you are getting it very clearly. This is a second type of binary fission. Draw the diagram and write the note also of it. Now we will move to the third type of binary fission. The third type of binary fission is irregular is done, longitudinal is done, and the third one is transverse binary fission. In this transverse binary fission, the cytoplasma or the cytokinesis takes place at the transverse axis, and the example of this transverse binary fission is, the example for this I can take is paramecium. Paramecium is the organism where I will be showing you how the division is taking place. This is one organism which is also told to have a sleeper shaped body, and even the cilia is present all around their body. So you need to draw this, and the nucleus will be present inside it. Now when the division start in this kind of organism, it become like this, and the nucleus starts to divide into two. So the transverse means it will be divided like this, and one nucleus will be in one side of this plane and the other nucleus will be on the other side of the plane. So the cytokinesis has taken place in the transverse way. You can observe it here. And then I told you it will be having cilia all around it. So you should draw the cilia also. Then this parent cell, after division, there will be the formation of two daughter cells, each with one nucleus. Two daughter cells are formed here. Now you see, transverse binary fission in paramecium. Firstly, you can see the slipper-shaped organism, and then how the division, when it started, this cytokinesis is taking place in the transverse way. And then the two organisms is separated and they will be always identical. As I told you that all the offspring of asexual type are morphologically and genetically identical. So this is the third type of binary fission based on the plane of cytokinesis, how the cytokinesis is taking place in the organism. Yes. Now we will be moving to the multiple fission. In the multiple fission, binary, I told only two daughter cell will be formed, but in multiple fission there will be many daughter cell formed, and the example I can give you is Plasmodium. Plasmodium, which causes the disease, that is malaria. So how this organism multiply? When there is a parent cell, there will be the nucleus, and when the division start inside the parent cell, that time inside the parent cell there will be formation of multiple nuclei inside it. There will be multiple nuclei formation, and each nuclei will be surrounded by a bit of cytoplasm all around itself. This happens in case of this multiple fission. So there won't be any space left. Completely lots of nuclei will be formed, and those nuclei will be covered or encircled by the cytoplasm, and when this ruptures, the cell ruptures, all the nuclei with the cytoplasm is released out, and each is a new individual. So due to this multiple fission, there is formation of multiple new organism from only one parent cell. This is multiple fission, and we have discussed the topic, that is fission, which is one kind of asexual reproduction. In asexual, first fission is done, and then we will be talking about budding. So take note of all this, what is getting discussed. Asexual reproduction is budding. Budding is the outgrowth on the parent body. This outgrowth on the parent body, it is also termed as the bud. The bud are getting formed on the parent body, and then it get detached. When it get detached, then it will form again a new individual. This happen in case of the budding, right? Yeah. Now you might be thinking you have heard about Hydra yeast. Yes, this is also a pre-taught topic, but this budding, what you have to understand in this is two things, that this budding outgrowth on the parent body, it will be on two different ways. It can be either exogenous or endogenous. Yes, there are again two types of this budding. This budding will be of two types, exogenous budding and the other type will be endogenous budding. In this exogenous budding, the bud formation or the outgrowth will be on the outer side of the organism. That is, I can tell you the example, that is yeast or in Hydra. So in yeast cell, what you will observe is there is a cell which will be having the vacuole and the nucleus, right? And when the bud is getting formed, means there will be an extra outgrowth. In this, there will be the vacuole and the nucleus. This nucleus will divide. So I can show you the division here also, that it gets elongated to divide and get distributed. So when this nucleus is divided in both the side, then there will be the bifurcation of this bud. Means the bud will get detached from the parent body and can form the other individual. And in case of yeast, there is one more thing which happens, is the chain formation. There is a vacuole, a nucleus, and then there is one more bud which becomes a parent, and it leads to the formation of another bud above it. So there is a kind of chain formation in case of the yeast cell. In Hydra, you know, there are tentacles and there is a bud formation, and that bud get detached and again form a new individual. It is exogenous budding. The bud formation is outside the body of organism. But here in endogenous, which will be quite new to you all, so listen to it very carefully. This endogenous budding, it means the bud formation is inside the body of the organism. Inside the body of organism means, I can tell, if I give example, then only it will be easy to understand. Spongula. Spongula is that organism which is a fresh water porifera. Yes, it is found in fresh water, and only porifera that is present in the fresh water. And this spongula is having a body design, that is, it is porous, and it will be present on the substratum. It is having porous body with the opening and present on the substratum, and there will be also body wall which is present inside it. Now, since it is endogenous, means the bud formation will be inside the body wall. So the body wall which is here, there will be the formation of the bud. These buds are getting formed inside this, and this will be liberated out through the opening. So try to understand the structure of a spongula. It is having porous body, it will be having the body wall inside, and inside the body wall there will be the presence of, I can say, the presence of the bud over it. And one more thing to be noted, bud in case of endogenous budding or spongula, we call it gemmules. Not to be forgotten, because this type of example and terminology has been asked in board exam also. So do remember what is gemmules. It's the same thing, bud, which is present inside the body of spongula, right? Gemmule. Now, there is the structure of this bud or gemmule. How you will know that the bud which is present here, how it look like, what are the part in it? Yes. So, I will be telling you here. this gemmule structure. So when we draw the gemmule structure, there is the central mass of cell. This central mass of cell will be filled with numerous cell inside it. This cell will be filled here. This is central mass of cell which further give rise to the body part. This is the central mass of cell. And this central mass of cell is surrounded by gelatinous material. It will be completely surrounded by gelatinous material. So that this gelatinous material should protect the central mass of the cell. And this central mass of cell is also called as archaeocyte. It is also called as archaeocyte, and I told you this is gelatinous material. Now, these are the cells which have been formed. Now, it is also having one opening. That opening is termed as micropipe. So what I labeled just now, archaeocyte for the central mass of cell, which is covered by gelatinous material just to protect the cells, and the opening which is called micropipe, from where these can go out. And there is this gelatinous substances which is also having the spicules. These spicules are present, which is needle-like structure inside the gelatinous material, which is also endoskeleton. So you can see here, gelatinous material is having the needle-like structure all over it, and this is called as spicules. This is called as spicules. So see the diagram of it. Endogenous budding spongula is the example. The buds are called the gemmules. It is having the central mass of cell called as archaeocyte, which is covered by the gelatinous substances, and it is having the spicules in it. Now, when the, I can say, the cells or the buds, when it is matured, I have shown you one more diagram. So that will be coming out through the opening of that spongula body, right? So when this will be coming out, and it has to get attached to the substratum. So the substratum attachment is done with the help of this micropyle. This micropyle will be getting attached to the substratum, and this central mass of the cell will be forming the body part of the organism. And the new organisms are formed through these buds or the gemmules. From each gemmules, one new organisms are getting formed. These cells will lead to the formation of whole body part. This is the budding. The other type is spore formation. In spore formation, it is also one type of asexual reproduction in which there is new organism formed with the help of only unicellular reproductive structure. Unicellular reproductive structure, which is called the spore. So with the help of spore formation, new individuals are getting formed. So I told you, these spores are unisexual reproductive structure, which will be, I can say, motile or non-motile. Now, there are three types. First, let me list that, and then I will tell you. The first type of this is zoospores. Second type of this is conidia. And the third type of this one is sporangiospores. So these unicellular structure, it can be motile. I can say motile means It will be having the ability to move in case of zoospore, non-motile in case of conidia and spore angiospores. They are not having cilia flagella, because of that they can't move. Now these are the three ways how the spore formation will be taking place and how the reproduction will take place in some of the organism. In this zoospore, the example of these zoospore will be Chlamydomonas. In this kind of organism, Chlamydomonas, this organism, they are having a structure like this with two flagella and a nucleus. So inside a cell, there will be the multiple cell of this Chlamydomonas which will be multiplying and will be forming the new individual. So these are Chlamydomonas, right? Zoospore formation. This is one zoospore. So there will be many zoospore which will be formed inside one cell. And each zoospore will be leading to the formation of many new individual. Means each one will be forming one individual. So there are many. If I draw like this, so inside this there will be many zoospore which is getting formed, and this will lead to individuals, new individuals, right? This is in case of Chlamydomonas. In case of Conidia, this is a non-motile spore. Non-motile spore, and this can't move, non-motile, and this Conidia are always present in chain. So whenever you will learn or you will read about Conidia, what you will see that the organism is always resembling in chain. The example of Conidia is Penicillium. Penicillium is the example, and it is having a body. Its body will be having the branches, and above the branches, from the lower end, there arises spherical structures. These structures are called as conidia. These spherical structures are the conidia in the penicillium. This conidia, from the lower end it is getting produced, and at the upper end it will get detached. And after getting detached, each of these conidia will be forming a new individual. This is the second type of spore formation, conidia. The third one is sporangiospore. In sporangiospore, the spore formation is taking place, and the example is fungi like rhizopus and mucor. In case of rhizopus and mucor, the new individuals will be formed. So these spores, where it is present, how it is getting formed, for this I will be telling you one diagram. This is the stolon, and it will be having the rhizoid part, which is the undeveloped, root, and above it there will be sporangiophore. Sporangiophore is the part which is like the stem, and it will be bearing the sporangium. This sporangium will be having many spores in it. These spores will be present inside it, so it is called sporangium. It is called sporangium. This is sporangiophore, this is stolon, and this is rhizoid. This is rhizoid. So when this sporangiophore, let's say if it is matured enough, then the spores will be bursting, and means the cells will be open up and the spores will be liberated outside. So when the spores are liberated outside, it will again, each spores are capable of forming a new individual. This is sporangiospore, which is non-motile. So in spore formation, there are three types: zoospore, conidia, sporangiospore. This is the motile one, this is non-motile, this is also non-motile. Now moving to fragmentation and regeneration. Fragmentation and regeneration, as the name also suggests, that the fragment of any individuals will lead to the formation of new organism or species. So fragmentation, in case of, if I take example, Spirogyra, so they are having an elongated structure which is also having the septum. This is the division. So each division is also termed as septa. I can label it like this, and it will be having spiral chloroplast in it, and each cell is having nucleus. Now when this cell is matured enough, it will be broken down into fragments. In any way it can be broken down, and from each fragment, when the fragmentation is done, so there is this pieces of these organisms, and each piece or part of the fragment will form a new individual or the new organism again. This is fragmentation, which takes place naturally. But accidentally, if it is done, we call it regeneration. And the example of regeneration is planaria. We can illustrate this regeneration with the help of the diagram of planaria. So I will just draw the diagram simply to make you understand. Planaria is very simple organism, and when this planaria accidentally, if it is cut into pieces, then each piece will lead to the formation of a new individual. So this is all about fragmentation and regeneration. In this, each fragment is capable of forming new organism, and in regeneration it occurs accidentally, and from each pieces there is the formation of new individual taking place. So today what we have learned in this class, that there are different types of asexual reproduction. First is the fission, budding, spore formation, fragmentation, regeneration, and there are other type also which we will be continuing in the next video. That will be about vegetative propagation. So for recapitulation, fission, there are three different types based on the cytokinesis, plane of cytokinesis, how the cytoplasm is getting divided. Irregular binary fission is there. Means first the binary fission, irregular binary fission, and then there is the longitudinally binary fission, and then transverse binary fission, and there is multiple fission. One more thing I want to tell here, that in the binary fission, since the organisms is divided into two parts, so it is very important to note that these organisms, which is the amoeba, let's say that amoeba is getting multiplied into two daughter cells, right? And again this can multiply into two daughter cells, and this can also multiply into two irregular shape amoeba, two daughter cells. It means in the binary fission, the organisms are continuously formed and they are immortal. They don't die because the parent cell itself is continuously getting divided. So this is in the fission, which I have told you with the help of diagram also, and you should remember that the binary fission organisms are immortal. Budding, exogenous budding is there and endogenous. In exogenous, I have told two examples. There is hydra and yeast, where the bud formation takes place outside the body, and in the endogenous, the bud is formed inside the body of spongula. That bud is called gemmules. I have told you the structure of gemmule, how it is, and spore formation three types. Zoospore is there, which is motile. Conidia is there, non-motile, and then one more type, spongiospore, which is non-motile, and fragmentation, regeneration. The body is broken into pieces, and each piece of fragment can lead to the formation of new individual. Now, coming to the assignment, your assignment will be uploaded in the ERP to check it, and the questions given in the assignment, first one is, write about the types of asexual reproduction, what you have understood till now, and then you have to tell what is the different type of spore formation with the help of example. So do that assignment and go through the video properly again if you have any doubt, and do write the notes. Thank you.